This video around Kappa presents a very easy to understand, and easy to calculate interpretation of the Einstein field equation, and especially the function of Kappa. The information about the Einstein field equation, that I could find on internet, indicates that the equation impacts a lot of tensors, and are very difficult to calculate. I found many of these calculations, in extremely difficult to read papers. I never found some concrete calculations about the velocity of planets, and other kinds of data, that are interesting to know about. I read about all these tensors and equations, and I believe that they are all true. However, my point of view is that all these tensors together are summarized and compressed in a clear equation with just three parameters. The Einstein field equation tells us. Equation 1. Rearranged, we find the proportionality factor kappa. Equation 2. The Einstein field equation tells us to what exactly kappa means. Equation 3. I wanted to know, what proportionality is this about? What are we comparing in numerator and denominator? This is how I found my answers. Because in this equation we find g, the gravitational constant of Newton, I presume that this equation tells us about mass. So, I add a mass, m in numerator and denominator. Equation 4. I think it is interesting to get half m c squared in the denominator, because that is the kinetic energy of that mass. We divide numerator and denominator by 2. Equation 5. We recognize g, m, the gravitational constant, times central mass. Equation 6. V, being the orbiting velocity of the planet, and d being the radial distance between the planet and the central mass, the Sun. This equation is the same as equation 7. A, being the acceleration at the surface area, and d being the radial distance between the planet and the central mass, the Sun. From these equations, we derive equation 8 and 9, by replacing gm by a, 4 pi r squared. Because 4 pi gm equals a, 4 pi r squared, acceleration times the surface area. This means g alpha gamma, the Einstein tensor, equals the outwards acceleration, times the surface area of the mass, the central mass. Equation 8. And also, g alpha gamma, the Einstein tensor, equals the velocity squared times the radial distance. Equation 9. T alpha gamma, the stress energy tensor, equals the kinetic energy of that mass at light speed squared. Equation 10. Kappa means the value of the proportionality in planetary motions in cubic meters relative to the kinetic energy of that mass. Summarized. Gravitational motions, g alpha gamma, are equal to, or are, caused by the kinetic energy of a semi-closed system, half m dot c squared. M dot c squared is the energy of this semi-closed system at the origin of this mass, m equal to that portion of that energy field, E equals m dot c squared. The Sun is a general motor GM, gravitational constant times mass, driving the planets in an orbit based on the kinetic energy of the central mass. In this case the Sun, being equal to half a meter dot c squared with a universal constant proportionality factor kappa. The accelerated cubic meters of GM are spread over a sphere with 4 pi r squared. So, on any place inside the solar system, the product of the acceleration times the distance equals that amount of cubic meters, GM. Equation 15. Please pause the video to read these calculations carefully. This video around Kappa presents a very easy to understand and easy to calculate interpretation of the Einstein field equation, and especially the function of Kappa. I think I found a very easy way to understand how the left-hand side and the right-hand side are coupled by Kappa. In that way we can derive a very easy way to understand how G micro nu and T micro nu are coupled and what it is all about. If you want to check the calculations, please click on the link, selection Einstein field equation on G Newton. You will find the calculations for all planets of our solar system.